In the name of Jesus, to the farewell service of our dear beloved brother, husband, Mr. Charles Ebun Ilawole. I pray that God, in His mercy, will favor us with His presence today in Jesus' name. Shall we pray? Our Father in heaven, we thank you, for in all things we should give thanks unto you. Thank you for this day. Thank you, Lord, for the purpose of our gathering this morning. Thank you for the life and times of our departed brother. We adore you. Father, please accept our praise and thanks in Jesus' name. Father, this morning, as we gather for this farewell service, we ask the Lord you favor us with your presence in the name of Jesus. We ask for garment of praise in the place of money this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we ask the Lord you send your spirit of comfort upon your family, family of our brother, and your church in the mighty name of Jesus. At the end of it all, Lord, let your name and your name alone be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. We move into praise and worship by the choir of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. With me here today, we have our pastor, senior pastor of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Promised Land Parish, Pastor Tunjil Idowu. And my name is Dio Thomas. You are welcome all in Jesus' name. Over to you, choir.
You are Yahweh. 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 Alpha and Omega.
your feet, bow before your throne.
We'll be taking our first Bible reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 15. We'll take verses 55 to 58. And to take the first Bible reading is the daughter of our beloved brother, Miss Kemi Ilawole. Let's welcome her.
Hello, hello.
Amen.
1 Corinthians 15:55-58. O death, where is your sting? O hate, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain.
God bless you. Next on the order of service is going to take a hymn. To God be the glory. We can get that on the pamphlets on the page. Item 7, praise the Lord. To God be the glory. Over to you, Father.
Yeah.
Bible reading for this fearless service for our dearly beloved brother, father, Mr. Charles Ebun Ilawole, will be taken from the first book of Thessalonians, chapter 4, verse 13 to 17. And to take us on this second reading is the son of our beloved father and brother, Mr. Victor Ilawole. Please let us welcome Victor.
But I would not have you to be ignorant, brother, concerning them which are asleep, that ye not ease of sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if, verse 14, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. Verse 15. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. Verse 16. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the triumph of God, and then in Christ shall rise first. Verse 17. Then we are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. So shall we be ever with the Lord.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. Next on the order of our service is a hymn, Rock of Ages, Clear for Me, to be under by the choir.
not a little of my hands can fulfill the Lord's demands. Could my sin or respite know? Could my tears forever flow? All could never see me rest. No more stand and save my grace. Nothing in my hands I bring, simply to thy cross I cling. Make it come to thee for grace, helpless look to thee for grace. While I to the fountain fly, wash me, Savior, for I die. While I draw this fleeting breath, when my eyes shall close in death, when I soar to a world so long, see me on a judgment throne. Rock of ages, well for me, let me hide myself.
Next will be Dr. Shogun Ekwerekwolu to please come to the podium to give us the biography of a departed brother, Daddy, Mr. Shogun Ekwerekwolu. Please let's welcome Dr. Shogun Ekwerekwolu.
Thank you all for coming. The biography of Charles Ebun Ilawole. Charles Ebun Ilawole was born on February 23rd, 1969, in Idiogba, the largest local government area of Ondo State. He commenced his education career at Anglican Primary School, Idiogba, 1976 to 1981. He further attended Community Grammar School, Idiogba, 1981 to 1986. He was admitted into Ondo State College of Education, Ikere Ekiti, 1992 to 1994. Following the tradition of his well-educated family, Charles proceeded to the University of Ojo, where he obtained a bachelor's degree in English in 1997. Following this, he attended the Obafemi Awolowo University, Ile-Ife, where he further obtained a master's degree in public administration in 2003. With a strong penchant for learning, Charles further obtained a degree in law from the National Open University, Lagos. He was an astute professional, a member of the Institute of Public Management, Nigeria Institute of Public Relations, and a fellow of the Institute of Information Management. He joined Chevron Nigeria Limited, Agura Independent Project Team, in 2006 as a field public affairs representative in the company's policy, Government and Public Affairs Department. He later moved to another role in the Social Performance and Planning Division as a Social Performance Representative, a position he held until his demise on July 19, 2020. Charles was a man of faith, a born-again Christian and a member of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Promised Land Province in Lekki, Lagos. Was a worker in the church, where he was also trained as a minister at the Christ the Redeemer School of Disciples, where he obtained a certificate in a graduate course in 2016. And also the Redeemer's International Leadership Academy, where he obtained both a certificate and a postgraduate diploma in pastoral leadership in 2018. Mr. Charles, as fondly called, was a very optimistic person who always saw the bright side in every situation. He was full of life, calm, and easygoing. He embodied everything good, bright, and positive in this world. Charles will be remembered for his calm disposition, excellent professionalism, and the righteous Christian life he lived to his transition into glory. He survived by his wife of 19 years. He was survived by his wife of 19 years marriage, Mrs. Mabel Ilawole, his children, Fayo Ilawole, Kemishola, Victor and Motorayo, his aged mother, brothers and sisters. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Shogun. Next on the order of service is going to have a tribute, and there are five categories of people will be taking the tribute of our brother, Charles Ebun Ilawole. First on this category is, on behalf of his colleagues at work, and he's going to be joining us on Zoom. Representing his colleagues is the General Manager, PGPA Chevron, Mr. Ebimaje Brikin.
Hello, good morning, everyone. I guess I'm audible, really, just testing. Good morning, everyone. Today it's a very sad thing. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
Yeah. On behalf of the colleagues of Charles Ilawole at Chevron, where he worked until he passed away, I will be speaking a few words on behalf of all of us. Charles Ilawole was a very committed employee of the company he worked for, supporting Chevron. He was an integral member of the team. Basically, his work was to support Chevron in contributing to society, having Chevron make the right social impact in the communities where Chevron operates and in the country in general. And Charles was very impactful in carrying out those roles. As I listened to Charles's son giving the first reading from 1 Corinthians 15, 58, and I will just read this. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. I can tell you, Charles took his work at Chevron like a ministry. He put in his best. He didn't by any means even steal Chevron's time in the way he worked. You didn't have to be told that Charles was a Christian, because his attitude, his composure, the way he spoke with people, the way he related with people, really portrayed the fact that there was something really greater sitting in him that made him conduct himself in the way and manner that he did, working with us at Chevron. He didn't have any title, pastor, brother, or whatever you probably want to call him. But his relationship with people exemplified all of those attributes that the Christian faith actually demands of us. For us, it's very, very, very painful that Charles left us the way he did. But we are very convinced in our spirit and in our minds that Charles has gone to be with the Lord. We all here have to continue to condole ourselves, and we pray that God in his infinite mercy and grace will be with the immediate family and keep them strong and provide for them, because God is the provider of for everyone. We cannot really question God why this has happened. But we do know that Charles himself has played his role fully, as was expressed in 1 Corinthians 15:58. So on behalf of his colleague at Chevron, where he last worked, I want to say thank you to everyone that is here today to give Charles his befitting burial as he moves on to glory. Thank you very much.
Praise God. Thank you so much, Mr. Abimadie Brikini. Next on the category of people who are going to give tributes, representing his friend is Engineer Oladele Oletan. Let's welcome Engineer Oladele, please.
Charles is my childhood friend. We grew up together from childhood. We are so close. And my wife happened to be Charles' wife cousin. And Charles is a trusted friend. He's so reliable. And I always remember his call wake me up every morning. He would call me, "Dele, what do you mean?" I don't want to see Charles. I don't want to see his corpse. That is why I refuse to come around and check on his corpse. I want to keep his memory while he was alive, the good time we spent together. And I'm going to miss him so much. And I believe Charles will live forever, and we're going to see one of these days. Thank you.
Thank you. It's strong. Bless you, sir. Praise God. Next is going to be from one of his in-law. And representing the in-law, we have Reverend Shola Adebawo.
It is indeed very painful to be sharing the amazing life of Charles so early in his journey. But in all things, we give thanks. I'm Charles's brother-in-law. He's married to my younger sister. When Charles married my sister, the family gained a son, and I gained a brother. It is rare, besides the differential in surnames, it's very difficult to know that we are not children of the same parents, because the relationship is quite cordial. As a matter of fact, we work together in the same office, the same department. So beyond being an in-law, is a brother, a friend, and a colleague. There will be times more to share the testimony of the impact the life of Charles has made. And I'd like to advise all of us not to worry, because I know that Charles is a child of God. He was and still is. By the grace of God, we will meet at the resurrection. Thank you.
Thank you, dear Reverend. From his cousin, we have Mr. Olutosi Lawole. Please.
Uncle Charles lived a very short but impactful life. I'm standing here today as a testimony of the impact he had on members of the family. I could remember back then in 2013 when he called me.
I told him yes.
I told him yes. He said, okay, send me your CV. I'll follow.
No, make a record real.
That was my first job. And since then, he's been a big brother, always calling to check on me, always calling to check on everybody. He's somebody that loves everybody in the family. Just last month, he came visiting at my
place. Just sitting in the cafe.
Top of his discussion with me was, how do we help the younger ones that need help? We need to look at how to fix people. This is the kind of person Uncle Charles was. He's a man that loves everybody. He wants to see everybody. I never expected I'll stand here to him so early. I expected Uncle Charles to live 80, 90 years, but we can't question God. I want to thank God for the life he lived, and I pray that God should hold us as a family. Thank you very much, everybody.
Thank you, Mr. Tosin Ilawole. His neighbors will be represented by the prince. The prince.
Good morning, everybody. I am short of words. This great man lying down here, Charles, has been a father to me personally. I think the kind of life he lived, I appreciate him even at death. I never knew this kind of man I met at this time in life, that he have to leave us so early. I met Charles 2015, January 13th. And ever since then, we met each other. We were living as father and son. Whatsoever I want, whatsoever that is confusing me, I meet him personally. He talks to me as a father. The most important place is where we gather as the landlords of this few area where we are growing. He has been a very good instrument on making things to work out in the environment where we stay. He's been a brother, he's been more than a friend. He's just a very simple human being, and I have been living, looking at his age and looking at
the kind of person he is, I think, I don't know how to give Max, but I gave him 80-something percent. He has been so useful to us in this environment. We miss him so much. We miss him so much. When I saw him in the hospital, I didn't believe that this is that man. So I just want to beg everybody, and I still want to say something, that we should not look at this world the way we are looking at it. People should not be saying, who are you? God has the final say of everything. Do not worry. For me, even as a human, I don't judge. But I have said that if God looks things the way we do, he's already in heaven. And I know that this death is something that is inevitable. Myself, on behalf of myself, the landlord, his environment, the neighbors, the friends, we are saying that this gentleman lived a very good and perfect life. And I want us to stay and emulate him. There are so many things he taught me. There are so many things we spoke about because I'm so close to him. It's just dawned on me now when I remember some certain things this man told me not up to 1 month. Well, I just have to leave that. I'm only saying that wherever he is, he will rest in the bosom of the Almighty God. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Mr. Prince. May the Lord comfort all of us in the name of Jesus. Next on the order of service will the special number, and that will be taken by the Choir of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Promised Land.
Troubled by the past, friend to say
our brother, Charles Ebun Ilawole, once allow you to watch with us at Redeemed Christian Church of God, Promised Land, and to give us a short message for this service. Is a pastor from the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Promised Land, Pastor Tuji Idowu. Please join me to welcome our pastor, Tunji Idowu, for the message. Thanks.
Part of what comes with pastoring is that sometimes these things that we do are not relating to those a little bit distant from us, but those that are actually up close and personal. Charles was not only my brother worshiping in the same church, but we were also colleagues at work. You heard his tribute read. The division where he worked, I headed some years ago, and I got to know him even at closer range. So it's a bit tough, but it comes with the job. And on behalf of both his colleagues at work, as well as his brethren at church, we want to commiserate with his wife, his children, other family members. And our prayer is that the Lord will uphold you, the Lord will comfort you, the Lord will fill the void of his absence. We know that we are missing him because of his physical absence, but we can rest assured, comforted, that he's only left us to go to a better place where he's even in the midst of a stronger and an eternal family. And one day we will join him there, all of us that accept Jesus as Lord and Savior. And we'll be together rejoicing forevermore. And so as we go into the word, we ask that the Father of comfort, the God of comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles, will comfort everyone, colleagues, in-laws, family, neighbors, brethren. The Lord will comfort us all. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that these words that we will share over the next few minutes will minister to every soul, and the name of the Lord will be glorified. In Jesus' matchless and mighty name, we have prayed. My message is titled, and it's a question, how are you playing? And the scripture to hinge it on is 2 Timothy chapter 4, the first 8 verses of 2 Timothy chapter 4. I read from the New Living Translation, and it says, I solemnly urge you in the presence of God and Christ Jesus, who will someday judge the living and the dead when he comes to set up his kingdom. Preach the word of God. Be prepared whether the time is favorable or not. Patiently correct, rebuke, and encourage your people with good teaching. For a time is coming when people will no longer listen to sound and wholesome teaching. They will follow their own desires and will look for teachers who will tell them whatever their itching ears want to hear. They will reject the truth and chase after myths. But you should keep a clear mind in every situation. Don't be afraid of suffering for the Lord. Walk at telling others the good news and fully carry out the ministry God has given you. As for me, my life has already been poured out as an offering to God. The time of my death is near. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race and I have remained faithful. And now the prize awaits me, the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on the day of his return. And the prize is not just for me, but for all who eagerly look forward to his appearing. May the Lord bless the reading and the hearing of his word, and may it bear fruit in the souls of our hearts in Jesus' name. This was Apostle Paul writing to his disciple, Timothy. And some things we can gather from here are as follows. Number one, life is a stage, and everyone plays their part. Whether we realize it or not, life is a stage, and you are playing your part. The question then is, how are you playing? According to what script are you playing? According to whose script are you playing? Yours? The world's? The critics? The influencers? But anybody who's familiar with plays, movies, will know that it's the director who dictates how things go on the set. The actor cannot just act anyhow. He or she, as a professional, must act according to the script given to them. The one who made the world wrote the script. It has its design. And he scripted how we are to play. Maybe drama is not your thing. Maybe you love football. In a football match, it is the coach that comes up with tactics. The players have to play according to the coach's tactics. The player that doesn't fit the pattern either doesn't get playing time or gets substituted if the pattern of play is different and is going to cost the team. God is not only the director of life, he's also the coach. He observes, he rewards, he supports. He gave the world Jesus Christ to restore the world to himself. And anyone and everyone who accepts Jesus receives salvation. Whoever does not receive it. Jesus' sacrifice made us to be adopted into his family and the family of Father God. God not only gave us Jesus, he also gave us the Holy Spirit to guide us through life, to help us play according to the script. We also have the angels attending to all believers. They are helpers to believers. And you have brethren and the church of God for mutual support and reinforcement. At the end of life, we will stand before God. Those who don't accept Jesus will be judged. Those who accept him will receive their rewards. If in life you choose to spurn Jesus, the Holy Spirit, and all that God made possible for you to live life successfully, if you choose to go off script and to write your own script, then you will have run out of excuses when you stand before him. Today, we are going to inter the remains of our brother. He left the day he gave up his last breath. We have to do what we have to do in the physical. But we know one thing. Charles chose to play according to the script of the director of life, because he gave his life to Jesus. He ran his life using the manufacturer's manual. He did not do life according to his own dictates. I ask again, how are you playing? How are you doing life? Are you still involved in schemes and wits and schemings? Or are you following what is in the manufacturer's manual? Charles was led in his conduct of his life by the Spirit of God. He did life as designed, and he role modeled it to his family and to those who were close to him. And that's why people can say, and it's not about saying good things about a dead one, but telling the truth, that by the mercy of God, by the grace of God, we have assurance that he has gone to a better place, and he has gone to be with his maker, he's gone to be with his Lord. You and I left behind still have time. If you are off script, if you're singing off tune, if you're playing out of pattern, if you are not in tune with God, if you have no relationship with him, you still have a chance before the last breath comes. In recent times, many times we've heard people say, oh, we did not expect him to go too soon. None of us knows where we are to go. And that's why we must make sure that we are on the right side of God in life. And it's not a hard thing. The Apostle Paul, who wrote to Timothy in the passage that we read, lived his life according to the script. He played according to the script. That was why with confidence he could say, I know I'm going to die soon. I'm not afraid. Paul was a young man when he passed away. He says, but I can face my maker, knowing that I have run the race and I have finished it. I have not left the job undone, and I have affected lives for him. My prayer is that when we reach the end of our lives, we will be able to hear from the Lord, well done, you good and faithful servant, come to your reward. And so I'd like us to bow and pray and give the Lord thanks for the life of our brother, husband to Mabel, father to Kemi, Victor, uncle, neighbor to Prince, brother in love to Shola, friend to Dilly,
and others, colleagues to many in Chevron, a good brother in faith to us at RCCG, the Promised Land. We give God thanks for his life. And we pray that his example will spur those of us behind. His love for Jesus, his faith, will ginger us to re-examine our own lives and to draw closer even to our Lord, our Maker, and our Savior. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. We say, be exalted. Thank you, Lord, for you don't count us out. You're the God of second chances who's always extending grace to us. And so today, as we reflect, we pray that wherever we have wandered away from you, your grace will draw us closer to you and bring us back home. And may we never wander away from you, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. And now I'm going to invite the family members to please come forward as I enjoin all ministers in the house and all of those online. As we pray for the family and commit them into the hands of the Lord. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise, we give you the glory, we give you the honor. We acknowledge you as the God of comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles. Father, please comfort your children. It is written, as the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord encamps around those who fear in him and who trust in him. The Lord will be your trust. The Lord will be your shield. The Lord will be your buckler. The Lord will be your strength. The Lord says he is the husband of the widow and the father of the fatherless. The Lord will play those roles in your lives in Jesus' name. In those down moments when you are alone, my sister, when you turn in bed and you're looking to reach out for your loved one and he's not there, I pray that the presence of the Lord will be mighty for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, as you children advance in life and certain milestones come and you're celebrating, I pray that you will not have any cause to look back and say, had I wished my father was here, or this would have happened or would not have happened if my father would not be here. I say that and I pray that because the Father of fathers will be there for you. He will do much more than you ask, much more than you imagine, in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will preserve our brother's legacy and the memories will remain precious, in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray for peace. We pray for unity. We pray that the household will remain strong. We pray that the Lord will preserve you in the faith, in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will do much more than you imagine, much more than you ask. The Lord whom Charles served and whom you have been serving is a faithful God. He will be faithful to you in the mighty name of Jesus. He is too faithful to fail. So there is no cause to fear, no cause to be worried. The Lord will meet you at every point of your need. Before you call, the Lord will answer you. While you are yet speaking the words, he will have heard you. In the mighty name of Jesus. His eyes are on the sparrow, and I know he watches over you. The Lord will be there for you. He will supply your needs according to his riches by Christ Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. Because all of our sisters, all of our family members, and mothers,
but they tell it's on for me. No, like it's connected here.
So this one, not that
place. Okay.
in Jesus' name. Our Father, we thank you for helping us this far. Trust in your love. Trust your love. Strengthen us and offer us. Commit this sacrament on God. Man that is born of a woman is a few days on earth and full of trouble. He goes and is kneeled down as the flower of grass. He passes away like a child of God in a place. In the midst of life, we stay in death. From whom shall we still help or pursue you? Our Lord, who is justified to be annoyed because of our sins. Lord God, most high, almighty God, holy Savior, and the most merciful, do not put us in painful agony of everlasting death. Lord, you know the secret things of our hearts. Do not be deaf unto our prayers. Most holy God, holy Savior, and our most merciful God, spare us. You are the most righteous God. Do not allow us to fall away from you because of death. Lord.
Sorry.
Oh, yeah.
As it pleases the Almighty God in His great mercy to resolve the soul of our dear brother Ebun Ilawole, who has left this place, and of a fact, without doubting the hope of resurrection into life everlasting through our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall transform our poor bodies into His own likeness, which is glorious, according to the mighty works by which He could subdue all principalities by Himself.
Quote,
and I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the death which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, say the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. And so, Father, we thank you once again, for you are the author of life, and to you, every life, every soul will return and give account. Thank you for the life of your son, Charles. Thank you for showing yourself mighty in his life during his stay here. Thank you for the greater life the more glorious one that he was now spending with you on the other side of eternity. Once again, Father, we commit his family and loved ones into your hands. As you showed yourself mighty to him in his own life, please continue to show yourself mighty to them. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. We're saying goodbye to the remains of our brother. And we look forward to when we will see him in a glorious state on the other side. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Peace at the time of grief. Peace even in the time of rejoicing. Peace in storms. Peace in calm. May the peace of God, which surpasses all human understanding, rest, abide with you, garrison your minds in Christ Jesus. Nothing in this world will rob you of God's peace. It is well with you in Jesus' name. Amen.
This is another problem.
People just need to cooperate.
Thank you. Father, there is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter, springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and a peace that endureth. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine, with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.